We have a great opportunity to enhance the experience, the education of all of our members.
When we went back to review the ASA curriculum, we needed to take a step back and say, okay, what do all actuaries really need to know?
There were really three driving forces that led us to believe we needed to make changes. One was the increased importance of predictive analytics to an actuary's career. A second trend was the emergence of short-term insurance coverage as an important part of the actuarial profession. A third was that the International Actuarial Association had a project to modernize their required curriculum for their member associations.
The ASA curriculum changes involved a better balance between short-term and long-term actuarial mathematics, two new components of the process, an exam on statistics for risk modeling, and then the practical application is really the predictive analytics assessment.
Actuaries have always done predictive analytics, but it's become more important than ever. Companies of all kinds and actuaries in all practice areas are collecting a lot more data, have the technical ability to process a larger amount of data. What they need now are the tools to successfully use that data to make good business decisions for their clients and for their employers. The new ASA curriculum is going to focus on five particular analytic techniques. That would be linear regression and time series analysis, principal components analysis, decision trees, and cluster analysis. We're going to test our candidates on predictive analytics using some procedures we've not done before. It just doesn't work to test analytics in a multiple choice environment or in a short answer environment. The only way to tell if a candidate really has mastered these techniques is to see them demonstrate those techniques on real data solving business problems. So our plan is to use what we're terming a proctored project.
The actuary skills are strengthened as they go through these changes. You know, it's going to give them background on predictive analytics, practical hands-on application, and really support the employer's needs in moving from big data to really business solutions. I am seeing the value of this at my company today. I've seen predictive analytics starting to really be used, for example, in policyholder behavior. You're able to drill down to certain key data elements and try to predict how the policyholder is going to react. There's more competition out there now, and if you're able to slice and dice the data and get a better understanding of either where your policyholders are going or where your target market is, and you're able to really focus in on those, that's going to give you a competitive advantage in the end.
In addition to the ASA curriculum changes, we're doing a variety of other things to bring predictive analytics to our members.
They've got research that is going on. They're implementing it into the curriculum. They're supporting it at continuing education events. They're supporting a seminar specifically on predictive analytics. And they're actually going through a pilot certificate program aimed at predictive analytics.
We've constantly been innovating how we educate and assess our actuaries. We've shaped our educational offerings to match the subject matter, adding e-learning modules, then having more complex assessments of what they've learned. We've added a decision-making and communication module. We've created in-person seminars such as the Associateship Professionalism course and the Fellowship Admissions course. Actuaries have always been problem solvers for their clients and for their employers. The enhanced education in predictive analytics will take that a step further, because the whole predictive analytics process is one of problem solving, from defining the problem to designing a solution to communicating the results. So within that core set of courses that we're designing for our candidates, they're going to experience that complete cycle and therefore have not only exposure to specific techniques, but the ability to solve a problem from beginning to end. These changes help the Society of Actuaries stakeholders across the board. We're enhancing the quality and rigor of our actuarial education to keep our commitment to move the profession forward.